I have a sad story that I need to tell about a young turtle whose name was Sibel, who woke up one morning not feeling quite well, because last night when it was late she accidentally ate what she thought was a delicious squishy jellyfishus, but instead it was a plastic bag. Oh my goodness, how did a plastic bag get out there in the water? A day in the life of a plastic bag. What shall I do with my plastic bag? Should I put it in the bin like a good citizen? Along comes a truck to pick it all up, but then where does it go now? Where does it go now? Where does it go now? I know. It goes to the dump and they tip it all out, along with the other rubbish you're throwing out. But then a wind comes along, it blows my plastic bag away. But then where does it go now? Where does it go now? Where does it go now? I know. It lands in a drain and gets washed by the rain. It goes for a ride, it's swept along with the tide. And where should it reach? It ends up at the beach. But then where does it go now? Where does it go now? Where does it go now? I know. Do you remember my good friend Sibel, the turtle whose tummy was not feeling well? She'd eaten my bag because she couldn't tell that it was not a delicious squishy jellyfishus. No, she'd eaten my plastic bag. Oh my goodness, how do I stop my plastic bag from getting out there in the water? There are some clever people out there who can take a plastic bag and turn it into a chair. Amazing, isn't it? Your shopping bags, Dorito packets, frozen peas too, they can melt it all down and turn it into something new. So why not give something different a go? You could recycle the plastic bags that you've got at home. It's time for something drastic. Let's get rid of the plastic so that turtles like Sibel can stay happy, safe and well.